Well, we see two numbers. This one in my hand is a 16 by 8. So those two numbers refer to the diameter and the pitch in inches. Hello everyone, welcome back to Motion RC. I'm James with another quick tip. Today's quick tip is going to be on diameter and pitch of a propeller and just trying to understand a little better what those things do. On every airplane propeller that you'll see on the website, they're always listed by their sizes. You'll always see two numbers. This one in my hand is a 16 by 8. So those two numbers refer to the diameter and the pitch in inches. The first number will always be the diameter. So this propeller is 16 inches. And the second number, which is 8 on this propeller, is the pitch of the propeller. But now it doesn't necessarily have anything to do, like there's no 8 inches here of pitch. What it really is telling you that in one revolution, in a stable platform with no wind resistance, no speed behind it, not attached to an engine, that if you rotate this propeller 360 degrees, it will move 8 inches. Whereas if it was a 6-inch pitch propeller, it would move 6 inches at a 360 degree. 3 would move 3 inches. So that's in essence what it's going to tell you. But again, that's going to be in a closed space. But that's how they do their best to measure propellers to let you guys know what you're looking for. And really this video, again, as a quick tip, is just an oversimplification. I hope you guys start a conversation in the comment section about, you know, all sorts of things. I love when the comment section goes nuts with more information. So you're definitely going to want to check there, because a lot of people smarter than me are going to be chiming in on this subject, I'm sure. But basically, the oversimplification of it is, a large diameter prop with a low pitch is going to be great for slowing down your aircraft, going to be great for vertical climbing. It's going to have more thrust and a little more efficiency, whereas a smaller diameter but a higher pitch prop is going to be better for top end speed, but will be harder to like slow down and land, if you will. That's why if you have a trainer aircraft, you'll find they tend to have bigger diameter, lower pitch props, because they don't need to be fast, whereas something like a racer aircraft could have a really small prop because you're just looking to get as much speed. And there's so many factors at play here. So, like you'd see a big Warbird, like a big Corsair, think real life scale aircraft, they're gonna have huge propellers on that because that machine is not very aerodynamic. It needs all that prop to be able to pull it up into the sky to do what it did. In essence, guys, you always want to refer, when it comes to finding the right prop for your aircraft, you always have to refer to either the electric motors manual or the gas engines manual that you have, because those motors and engines are capable of certain RPM ranges where they run best, and they will give you a range of prop sizes that are going to work, and it's up to you to figure out what works best for you. Because one thing, like with a lot of things in RC, there is not necessarily a perfect prop for every application. It depends on what you want to do with your aircraft. So if there's a range, you got to find what you find helps you fly the best in your aircraft. But at least the manuals for your motors and engines will give you a good basis point, and then it's up to you to figure out what pitch and what way you want to go, how many blades you want. There's so many things that can affect. But basically, as you see in this chart, large diameter, low pitch, good for thrust and slower for landings, and then lower diameter and a higher pitch is going to be, you know, much better for speed. So it's really up to you. We try to tend to think of it like your car. You wouldn't try to climb a hill in sixth gear. You're going to do it in first gear. So that would be like having a large diameter prop and a low pitch. But if you're on the highway and you're cruising, you want to be in fifth and sixth gear. You don't want to be in first, because that's going to not be very efficient for you at a low gear in that end. So that's the best way to think of it. And that's why these are quick tips, because that's where I'm going to end it before I talk myself into into saying something wrong. But guys, thank you so much for tuning in. And as always, please, in the comment section of this video, get busy telling me all about props and diameter. But I hope if you're a beginner watching this, that gives you just a semblance of information that's going to help you better choose the right prop for your application. And as always, guys, make sure to click that subscribe and notification bell, because our sub spin and win contest is going strong. Every Friday, we're giving away a prize. And all you have to do is be a subscriber and click that bell to be eligible to win something. Hit the like button on your way out the door if you like this video. And as always, guys, we'll see you next week with another quick tip.